For more Bang fun, be sure to check out the Bang Radio Hour podcast every week.
Hello, my name is Sergeant Bill Tuesday. I work for ESPN. My beat is the Social Network Investigations Department. Behind this door, our agents are constantly on the lookout for information from the various social networking websites of the Internet that will help us in presenting the most up-to-date sports news in the world. Come on in. Let's take a look around. You're now standing in the nerve center of ESPN's rumor-mongering efforts. If there's somebody out there that might believe something, this is where it comes from first. It's only bullshit if you believe it is. That's our motto around here. Say, Joe, how's it going?
Good morning, Sergeant Tuesday.
Joe here is in charge of our Brett Favre division. His job is to monitor all aspects of Brett Favre's life. His phone, his grocery scans, his credit reports. Any news today, Joe?
Well, not yet, but hey, hold on. Brett just updated his Facebook page.
Well, now you might get to see something. What does it say, Joe?
Well, it says, went to Denny's, and man am I stuffed. I probably had more than I should have, but boy, it sure was good. I think I finally had enough.
Better run it through the analyzer. Here in the SNI, we use the latest equipment to try to uncover the hidden meaning beneath the words these athletes actually say. That way, ESPN can give you angles on the news that no one ever thought legitimate.
It looks like we've got something here, Sergeant.
Oh, my sweet Jesus. Go to condition red. Total lockdown. Get me the hotline to SportsCenter.
Cowboys cornerback Tony Romo is looking like a future Hall of Famer at this point, wouldn't you say?
He's just the ginchiest, Neil. For the Cowboys to win the Super Bowl in their own home stadium, boy, it's just going to be awesome. I'm just glad that my kids are going to get to be able to see this.
Hang on, Scott. I've got a news bulletin here. Brett Favre has retired. Sources close to the Favre family say that Brett has made up his mind. And he made his retirement announcement on Facebook, saying, quote, I probably had more than I should have, and I think I finally had enough.
Well, no doubt Brett Favre's career has been stellar. He's easily a first ballot Hall of Famer. And now that he's retired, the game just seems to be missing something.
Well, of course, I agree. And to begin our overreaction to this stunning news, we're going to bring in two of ESPN's resident NFL experts, Chris Mortensen and John Clayton. Guys, thanks for coming on in such short notice.
Oh, sure.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
John Clayton, let's go ahead and start with you. Does Brett Favre's announcement come as any surprise?
Oh, it was hardly a surprise. Brett Favre's retiring is about as surprising as the sun coming up.
And now that it's been confirmed, it's really no surprise at all.
That was 2 weeks ago. Boy, did we end up with some egg on our faces. Well, no more. From here on out, the various research departments here at ESPN pledge that we will double-check everything thoroughly before running off willy-nilly with a half-baked story like that one. From now on, our agents will make sure their facts are correct before reporting anything. Hang on. What's that? He is. Are we sure this time? Okay, I'll take care of it. Well, it appears that while we've been talking, Brett Favre has decided to play again. Here's Ed Werder with the details.
This is Ed Werder, and I am reporting live from the wing of a 737 as it streaks northward toward Minnesota. Inside this airplane is Brett Favre and three Vikings players who were sent down to pick him up. And I assume we're headed for Vikings training camp.
Looking for more Bang fun? Be sure to check out the Bang Radio Hour podcast every week.